Hi, it's Maggie the Irish Gypsy here to bring you your March 2023 general reading, mid-month general reading. We're looking at the last half of March, and this reading is for our fish, the water sign of Pisces. Welcome. I hope everyone's doing well. Thanks so much for taking the time to be here, watch any of the videos on my YouTube channel. For those of you who like, share, and subscribe, a big shout out of gratitude for you as well. I appreciate everything that you all do. That helps me keep this going. So, Pisces, this is for you. Last half of March 2023, if your sun, moon, rising, or Venus sign is in Pisces. If you're cross-watching for a Piscean, it is also relevant. My bangs are driving me crazy. This is a general reading, so of course, as we always say, it'll resonate a little differently for everyone. So if you know any or all of your other signs, sun, moon, rising, or Venus, watch them, because each one can bring in a little additional information, a little, you know, extra perspective and insight. If you find that something really does resonate with you, it really does touch you, and you'd like to maybe peel it back a bit, take a deeper look, and reach out for a personal reading or information about that for yourself or as a gift for someone else, feel free to email me directly, maggie1mcguire@gmail.com. You can also click on the description link or click on the title of this video to see that contact info. I would be delighted to hear from you, and I can usually respond the same day with more information. I do offer quite a wide choice of readings for everyone. So if you're interested in that, send me an email. I'd love to hear from you. Okay, Pisces, let's see what the last half of March looks like for you. I am using the Tarot of Dreams and clarifying with the Radiant Rider-Waite. Okay, Pisces, we begin with a little conflict, Five of Wands. Internal conflict, external conflict. The basis of the conflict, it just kind of goes around and around and around and around. It might be petty drama, fighting with other people, but in kind of a petty, competitive sort of way, arguing, but going over the same thing over and over and over and over and over again without finding a resolution or a solution. Could be internal conflict within yourself, too. Doesn't necessarily have to be fighting with other people. With the Three of Swords, emotional pain, heartache, heartbreak, separation, estrangement. Of course, it's a general reading too, so the intensity will vary. There's conflict here about some pain that has been caused or that potentially might be caused in the future, like maybe a choice or a decision. Next, we have the Hanging Man, not taking any decisive action just yet. The Hanging Man puts himself in what appears to be an uncomfortable, awkward position in order to gain knowledge. You know, there's no action. He's kind of waiting, watching, seeing how things play out, gaining a different perspective, not acting just quite yet. Perhaps that's what some of the conflict is about. Do I do this? Do I do that? What do I do? With the Hanging Man, we have the Queen of Wands, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, the Queen of Fire. This is not you, this is somebody else. It's showing up as a queen, could be female, though. This is a general reading. So she's not taking action yet. She's thinking, or whoever this person represents, or they're taking their own sweet time. Maybe that's what the source of the conflict is. But then right next to it, we have the opposite, the Eight of Wands, fast movement, action, conversations, Cupid's arrows, travel for some of you. Very, very fast movement. With the Knight of Coins, Knights representing offers and opportunities. The Knight of Coins is the Knight of Earth, so this is a sure thing. All of the Knights move at a fairly swift pace. I've heard it often said that the Knight of Coins is a slow energy. None of the knights are slow, in my opinion. All knights have a mission and quest and they charge off. But the Knight of Coins is the Knight of Earth, so he may be a little slower than his other brother knights. He's more detail-oriented, he's more cautious. But it's kind of like something... Maybe that some planning went into this. But I definitely see an opportunity coming in. It might be a work or job opportunity for some of you, or traveling for that. From the bottom of the deck, for overall energy for the last half of March, Pisces, we have the Four of Swords. A card typically of rest, restoration, taking a temporary step back because you're tired, overwhelmed, exhausted. It can be a card of healing from illness. Maybe tired from this kind of conflict that's going on, whether it's internal or external or a combination of both. Let's clarify that overall energy of the Four of Swords. Five of Wands again. Conflict. The Four of Swords again. I think some of you are really tired of this conflict or this going over the same issue over and over and over again, whether it's just inside yourself, whether it's with another person or group of people or some combination. Let's clarify that Five of Wands, that card of conflict. Oh, too many cards. The Nine of Pentacles, independence, self-sufficiency, self-empowerment. Clarify the Three of Swords, pain, emotional pain, heartache, heartbreak. The Four of Swords just leaped out. It's traditionally called the miser card. It represents somebody who really doesn't want to. They want to keep themselves safe, and in order to do that, they don't open up. They're guarded, protected, closed off, or they don't want to share something because they don't want to go without themselves. It may be in some kind of situation or relationship that there is that this conflict, which has caused some emotional pain, clarify, has been, you know, somebody just being too selfish, too self-oriented, or too independent. Too independent in a negative way, meaning, for example, in a romantic relationship, it's somebody who says, yes, I'm in a relationship with you, yes, I'm committed, but they live their lives very much still as a single person. Maybe they're not dating anybody else, but they're still not including the other person in their life very much. Death, final endings. And I think somebody's drawn a line in the sand here, given some kind of ultimatum or something. Clarify the Hanging Man. Or the conflict is about, okay, I need to let this go because I'm not getting enough from this. This other person does not, I don't feel like the other side of this is enough for me. I don't feel like I'm in a partnership. It feels like you've been investing a fair amount in this, but not getting the same back in return. So you end up getting depleted and you're considering ending it. And I think there may be, for some of you, conversations about this with the other side. I say the other side because, you know, it feels like a partnership is at the root here, whether it's romantic or work or otherwise. Clarify the Hanging Man. Although there is a new opportunity coming in at the end here. I don't know if for love and romance, if that would be another person or another job or taking off or beginning immediately to look for other work. But let's take a look at that Hanging Man first, because he's gaining knowledge, not taking any action quite yet. The Knight of Cups, our Knight of Emotion, of love, charging in. The Ace of Wands, maybe somebody has been offered something here. You offered something to somebody, they offered something to you. They're taking their own time taking it. They're not taking it. clarify the Queen of Wands. There's some offer or opportunity for a new beginning here. I don't know if it's for an already existing relationship, which looks very rocky. Or it's a whole new one. What about this Queen of Wands? Who or what is this Queen of Wands to Pisces? The King of Cups, that would be you, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, and the Four of Cups, an offer being made, but nobody, but the person that it's being made to is not taking action yet. They're looking at it, but they're not doing, saying yes or not saying no, they're just kind of looking at it. And this is all sort of clarifying that hangman energy anyway. So there's been some kind of offer to you from someone else or by you to somebody else, but there's no movement. Somebody's thinking about it. Clarify the Eight of Wands. Ew. The Page of Cups. Little positive messages, flirtation, a love offer. Wheel of Fortune, divine timing and orchestration. Ace of Pentacles, perhaps some new love and romance here. So there's some sudden, unexpected new opportunity coming in. Some of you, this is going to be love. But here's the thing, it looks a bit tricky because I'm wondering if for some of you, this is like a relationship that's rocky or on the rocks or is in the process of ending or has ending, but there's still like all this messy energy with it. And then out of the blue, something new comes in. Again, if it's a job or something, it's the same. It feels like you're there's like this messy situation here and you're like, I don't know if I want to do this anymore. And then all of a sudden, and I literally mean all of a sudden because, you know, the Eight of Wands is already a fast action card. And the Wheel of Fortune is divine timing and orchestration, typically rather unexpected and sudden. There's some new opportunity coming in here. Let's clarify that Knight of Coins that's with it, that Knight of Earth. Because this is like a different opportunity than what you've already been embroiled in here. Something different. Oh, King of Swords, so we have another person here. Oh, and that Three of Swords again. Okay. So this is going to cause pain to somebody. I don't think there's any getting around this because there's two different situations going here. If this is love and romance, there's two different people here. If this is a job, work, partnership, some other kind of area of life, again, there's two different options and opportunities here. It feels like one, you're already in, you've been in for a long time, it's going through a lot of issues or difficulty. It feels like one person has been totally all in and the other person in and out or not so much, and somebody's feeling depleted here and they're like, I don't think I can do this anymore. It's either it needs to be this or I can't do this anymore. And then kind of right in the midst of that, here's this new offer or opportunity coming in rather unexpectedly, I believe, from a different source. So there's two different things going on here. So obviously a choice has to be made and it's going to cause pain to somebody. Either the new person that you say no to, or the new situation you say yes to, which will cause the old situation to feel pain, or saying yes to the old situation, which will cause the new situation pain. I mean, there isn't any getting around it here. It's like, it feels messy. So I totally understand why the overall energy for the last half of March is the Four of Swords. I mean, one of these enough represents feeling tired, exhausted, overwhelmed, so needing to take a step back and rest, recuperate, gain some perspective and some knowledge. But you've got it twice, so I can totally understand. You've also got the conflict, you know, the Five of Wands twice too, Pisces. So I can totally understand why you feel so worn out. I feel worn out just kind of looking at this. Okay, let's end with some advice, guidance, feedback, and spirit. Because this is a fairly short period of time, it feels like this is something that's going to continue to play out for a little bit. I mean, I only do videos that are, for roughly, time being fluid, around 2 weeks at a time. So, all right, advice, guidance, feedback for Pisces for the last half of March. Temperance, this is about balance. This is about staying grounded. This is not letting things come out the side of your neck. This is learning how to manage and to balance by staying firmly in the center. The Magician, also a very clear thinker and manifester. The Magician knows that in order to get what he wants, to manifest what he wants, he has to be very clear about it. And that may be something in terms of advice. It's more about the energy of the Magician that Spirit is giving you to be helpful, Pisces. Because as advice, the Magician represents being logical, making a plan, and enacting that plan. The Magician has a long road behind him. He's where he started off as some lowly apprentice, and now he's at the pinnacle, right? So this is somebody who knows it's not enough just to visualize. It's not enough just to sit on your couch and think positive thoughts. This is about taking your tools, your skills, your knowledge, your experience, your wisdom, all the lessons you've learned in life, and pairing those with the physical work to manifest something into reality. And in order to do that, you have to have a very clear, specific idea of what it is you want so you can make a plan to get it and immediately begin working towards that. So, Ace of Swords next, clear thinking, epiphany. I mean, this is about thinking clearly, thinking level-headed. Even if this is a situation which involves emotions, you know, and the Five of Swords, a hard-won victory. But you know, it can represent leaving somebody behind, but it needs to happen. I think Spirit, even if this is like an emotional romantic situation, I think Pisces, that Spirit here is saying, look, the decision and the choice will become clear to you when you take a look at clearly what you want in whatever area of life this is. For example, if this is a relationship, because we've got the Knight of Cups and the Ace of Cups, we've got two Three of Swords. So There's two things going on here. You've got this thing, which looks messy, and then you've got this new thing, right? The advice is, okay, if this is love, putting these two options aside, sit down, make yourself a list. It's about being clear-headed and logical about this. What kind of a relationship are you looking for? What's your ideal? Are you looking to build a home, a family, marriage? What? You need to be specific about that. What kind of relationship are you looking for? What kind of person do you think would be a good match for you and you for them? You know, be very specific and clear. And then, you know, and it's the same as if it's a job or some other kind of project opportunity. You have a clear idea, a clear list, a clear picture of what it is that you feel would honestly be best for you. And then you come back to the decision table and you look at this option and this thing over here and go, is this really going to get me to where I want? If not, then even if it's difficult, you need to move on from that. Is this new situation, you know, is it worth exploring at least? But you have to compare it to what you really want. Otherwise, you'll be all over the place. Because if you don't have a specific, clear idea of what you want and what you need, what you think is best for you, then you're just kind of meander all over the place and get involved in messy situations, right? So take a step back, rest, recuperate, gain some perspective, you know, have a very clear idea of what it is in this area of life that you want. And after that, come back to this choice thing. And if you're clear about what you want, then it should be clear which one of these paths has the most potential to lead to that. Might help you in your decision-making process. Works for pretty much any kind of decision-making process. If I choose path A, is this going to get me to or closer to my goal? If I choose path B, is this going to get me to or closer to my goal? That's how you make decisions, whether people, places, or situations remain in your life or not. Okay, Pisces, those are your messages for the last half of March. A little on the intense side, but it kind of felt that way, exhausting. I hope they were useful, helpful, gave you something to chew on, some food for thought. Again, if this did resonate with you and you would like to pull the curtain back a bit and take a deeper look at it and explore it, reach out for a personal reading for yourself or as a gift for someone else, feel free to email me directly, maggie1mcguire@gmail.com. Again, you can see that contact info by clicking the description link or the title of this video. I will see you all in a couple of weeks for the April general readings. Stay well until then, and I hope to see you back here again soon. Bye-bye.